Good morning, beloved.
Good morning.
Good morning and welcome to our very first, but not last, Bluegrass Mass. I've had people say, why in the world are y'all doing that? You're Episcopalians and you don't know how to clap, which is true. So that's what we're learning here today, is how to not do this, but this, and make a joyful noise. And joy is the theme of our worship today. It has been such a hard 14, 15 months, and there have been lots of sadness, lots of difficulties, lots of disunity. And I think music is the great unifier and the one that brings us great joy. So I'm delighted that y'all are with us. If you are new to the Episcopal Church, you are so welcome here. And all are welcome to God's table to receive communion. We're just glad you're here. So if you look around and you think, I don't know when to sit or stand or what have you, well, I'm here to tell you that after 35 years, I don't either, and it doesn't really matter, okay? I want to welcome, first of all, our guest preacher, Joshua Varner. Joshua is the canon for children and youth for the Diocese of Georgia, and he has been with us this weekend working with some of us in children's ministry and youth ministry. And for the sermon today, a little bit different. The children will not be going downstairs for story time. Don't go downstairs because you'll miss it. Our story time will be part of the sermon. So come forward and meet with Joshua because he has a story to tell you. Speaking of which, we are not going to do processional, recessional, which means for the dismissal, and you know I need our children to help because I don't do that very well, come forward and help me with the dismissal. And then y'all don't go away after that because we are going to close out our service with Foggy Mountain Breakdown. Okay. Go ahead. Give us a little. All right. Now that I've been embarrassed, I want to welcome Luke Teague and Catherine Robertson of Race Creek Revival. You are already blessing us with your presence. Thank you. The backstory which led to this service is Luke is actually a funeral director. Doesn't he look like, you know, your quintessential funeral director? And he was helping us conduct the service for the late Oliver Owens, one of God's great men. Oliver's main complaint about the Episcopal Church was our music. I can't figure that out. And at the conclusion of the service, Luke came up with his banjo and played I'll Fly Away. And of course, everybody in attendance was saying, I want that at my funeral. Well, you're not going to be around to hear it if you want him to play it at your funeral. So we're singing it today, but that's how I met Luke. I'm grateful to you and Catherine for sharing your musical talent. So that's how that came about. Let's see if there's any other thing I need to highlight. I've told the children that y'all come up here, not go downstairs. I will remind you all, especially if you have young people, rising sixth graders and older, about our late day at Mistletoe Park in July, and also in July, our food drive. So with that, I'm gonna hush up, which is something extraordinary for a preacher to do, and turn it over to Luke.
First song in your bulletin, Cindy just thought it'd be funny if I mentioned Will the Circle. It's kind of apropos because it is, after all, my theme song. It's about Undertakers. So y'all feel free to clap along and sing along. Sing. It won't bother us at all.
We
come rolling said to that undertaker, "Undertaker, please drive slow for that lady you are carrying. Lord, I hate to see her go. Will the circle be unbroken? By and by, Lord, by and by, there's a better home awaiting in the sky, Lord, in the sky." I went back home. My home was lonesome. Missed my mother. She was gone. All my brothers, sisters crying. Lord, my home was so sad and lone. Will the circle be unbroken? By and by, Lord, by and by, there's a better home awaiting in the sky, Lord, in the sky. There's a better home
sit down. You have to remain standing. And y'all, that was halfway pitiful. I warned them that if y'all didn't sing out and clap, I would make you do some parts again. Okay, now we're going to have a practice session. Was that hard? Was that hard? You know, if you were out, I'm dating myself, because no one else will. But you know, if you were out for a rock concert, you would be doing that. You would be getting your lighters. I am dating myself. Or you would be, you would be doing this, okay? You would be doing this. That's what we want to see, all right? Deep cleansing breath. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be His kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Keep, O Lord, your household, the church, in your steadfast faith and love, that through your grace we may proclaim your truth with boldness and minister your justice with compassion. For the sake of our Savior, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated.
A reading from the first book of Samuel. Samuel went to Ramah, and Saul went up to his house in Gibeah of Saul. Samuel did not see Saul again until the day of his death, but Samuel grieved over Saul. And the Lord was sorry that he had made Saul king over Israel. Lord said to Samuel, "How long will you grieve over Saul? I've rejected him from being king over Israel. Fill your horn with oil and set out. I'll send you to Jesse the Bethlehemite, for I have provided for myself a king among his sons." Samuel said, "How can I go? If Saul hears of it, he will kill me." And the Lord said, "Take a heifer with you and say, 'I have come to sacrifice to the Lord.' Invite Jesse to the sacrifice, and I'll show you what to do. And you shall anoint for me the one whom I name to you." Samuel did what the Lord commanded and came to Bethlehem. The elders of the city came to meet him trembling and said, "Do you come peaceably?" He said, "Peaceably. I've come to sacrifice to the Lord. Sanctify yourselves and come with me to the sacrifice." And he sanctified Jesse and his sons and invited them to the sacrifice. When they came, he looked at Eliab and thought, "Surely the Lord's anointed is now before the Lord." But the Lord said to Samuel, "Do not look on his appearance or on the height of his stature, because I've rejected him. For the Lord does not see as mortals see. They look on the outward appearance, but the Lord looks on the heart." Then Jesse called Abinadab and made him pass before Samuel. He said, "Neither has the Lord chosen this one." Then Jesse made Shema pass by, and he said, "Neither has the Lord chosen this one." Jesse made seven of his sons pass before Samuel, and Samuel said to Jesse, "The Lord has not chosen any of these." Samuel said to Jesse, "Are all your sons here?" And he said, "There remains yet the youngest, but he is keeping the sheep." And Samuel said to Jesse, "Send and bring him, for we will not sit down until he comes here." He sent and brought him. Now he was ruddy and had beautiful eyes and was handsome. The Lord said, "Rise and anoint him, for this is the one." Then Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the presence of his brothers. And the Spirit of the Lord came mightily upon David from that day forward. Samuel then set out and went to Ramah. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the second letter of Paul to the Corinthians. We're always confident, even though we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord, for we walk by faith, not by sight. Yes, we do have confidence, and we would rather be away from the body and at home with the Lord. So whether we are at home or away, we make it our aim to please him. For all of us must appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each may receive recompense for what was done in the body, whether good or evil. For the love of Christ urges us on, because we are convinced that one has died for all. Therefore, all have died, and he died for all, so that those who live might live no longer for themselves, but for him who died and was raised for them. From now on, therefore, we regard no one from a human point of view, even though we once knew Christ from a human point of view. We know him no longer in that way. So if anyone is in Christ, there is a new creation. Everything old has passed away. See, everything has become new. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark. Yeah, I know. Told you, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. But you have to stand. How many of y'all got your exercise in today? No one. You're doing it now. Oh, wait, two people. Okay. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark. Glory to you, Lord Christ. Jesus said, "The kingdom of God is if someone would scatter seed upon the ground and would sleep and rise night and day, and the seed would sprout and grow, he does not know how. The earth produces of itself first the stalk, then the head, then the full grain in the head. But when the grain is ripe, at once he goes in with his sickle, and because the harvest has come. He also said, with what can we compare the kingdom of God, or what parable will we use for it? It's like a mustard seed, which, when sown upon the ground, is the smallest of all the seeds on earth. Yet when it is sown, it grows up and becomes the greatest of all the shrubs and puts forth large branches, so that the birds of the air can make nest in the shade." And with many such parables, he spoke the word to them as they were able to hear. He did not speak to them except in parables, but he explained everything in private to his disciples. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Children, we all come forward and the rest of us can be seated.
I'll just add that
any children who want to come forward and bring their associated adults with them are welcome to do so as well. It is not required of anybody. I am going to be telling a story, and I'm going to be putting some stuff that on this table, and if you are all the way in the back, you may have trouble seeing. So that's part of why we're inviting you to come up here. You do not have to. You can sit on the ground. You can sit on the chairs. Yep, you can sit, stand right there. You want to sit right there? All right. You ready? Okay. My name is Joshua, and I work for the Bishop of Georgia, and I am thrilled to be with you all today. Today, I'm going to be telling you a story, and this story is kind of in here, but I want to start by just looking at this. What do you think this is? A box. I think you're right, and it's okay to answer when I ask you a question. Sometimes it's not okay to do that in a sermon, but in this case it is. It is a gold, but it does look gold, doesn't it? Cool. It looks like it's made out of wood, too. You can't tell this from looking at it, but it's kind of rough, too. So it's gold, and it's kind of wooden, and it looks a little bit rough and old. Well, you know, gold is valuable. And parables. This is a parable box, and parables are valuable. And it kind of looks old, sort of that rough thing. And parables are old. They're stories that were told so long ago. They've been passed down. Does that sound solid to you all? No? Sounds kind of, well, it's sort of solid, but it sort of sounds like it's sort of hollow in the middle there, too. Maybe there's something inside. What do you think? A person. There could be a person, I suppose. Could be. Do you think we should open it? Okay. Let's open it and see what we can find. Let's see. Oh, all right. So here's the first thing. This, it could be a blanket. It's a lot of yellow, sort of golden yellow. A what? A sun. It could be a sun. A circle of yellow. Maybe it's an egg yolk. Let's see. That's a lot of yellow. Let's spread it out right here. Now, could be. Now, there are some other things in here to help us tell this story. But there's nothing else to help us get ready for the story. So I guess we'll need to begin. Once there was someone who said such amazing things and did such wonderful things that people began to follow him. They followed him all around. And they listened to him, and he would talk about something he called the kingdom of heaven. And they didn't really understand what he meant by that. And so finally, they just had to ask him. They said, "What is this kingdom of heaven anyway?" And he said, "Well, the kingdom of heaven..." And he stopped for a minute. He said, "Well, The kingdom of heaven is like the smallest of all the seeds, so small that if I held it on the tip of my finger, you couldn't see it. It's so small. And he said, it's like that smallest seed, the mustard seed. And if someone came along and planted the seed in the ground, then it would start to grow. And it would grow and grow, and it would spread out. And it would become like a tree, exactly. And it would be not just any tree, but a large tree from such a small little seed. And it would be a tree, and it would be such an amazing tree that the birds of the air would come and they would fly around. Some of them would land on the branches. And some would nest there. And some might fly up in the sky. Some of them might even look like they were asleep. And they would make their nests in the tree. So that they had a home to come back to. See? Just like those. Mm-hmm. And maybe some of them would make them down near the ground. You never know. What he said the kingdom of God was like. Now, I wonder if any of these birds have names. What do you think? Do you think they have names? Yeah? What do you think their names are? You don't know? Hmm? Carl? Could be Carl. What other names could they have? Doug. Mm-hmm. Jason. Maybe one of them is named Cindy. I wonder if they're happy. Probably not. You think not? Why do you think they aren't happy? Because they're in the tree? You think they're happy because they made a new home? Yeah. They're happy that they made the tree grow. Maybe they made the tree grow. Do you think the birds maybe spread some more seeds? Maybe so. So maybe they did make the tree grow. I wonder how the person who planted that mustard seed feels. I wonder where you are in this story. Where do you think you are? Outside finding mice? Are you a bird? No? Okay. You could be outside. Oh, you did? You saw some bunnies? Oh, cool. Oh, really? Yeah. You'd be sleeping in the nest. Okay. What about you? You'd be playing outside at recess. That's a very good thing to do. I miss recess. I wonder where this tree really is. I wonder where all of this really is. Heaven? If it's small, then it's in the ground. If it's that small, it could be on your finger. That's right. Probably in the nest. Did it grow in the so tiny? Mm-hmm. Living. Where did he grow the thing? I wonder. I don't know. I wonder. So he was talking to everyone in heaven, so he grew it there. Interesting. Sometimes I wonder if I am part of the tree or part of a, or if I'm a bird, or if I'm a nest, or maybe sometimes I'm someone who's planting. And maybe sometimes it changes. You never know. You would not like to be a tree? Oh, the birds would stand on you. Well, that's true. I guess if you're a tree, the birds would stand on you. Oh. If you were an old tree, your leaves might fall off. You wouldn't like to be cold in the winter. It is nice to be able to have heat in the winter. You'd like to be a bird that could fly away? I'll fly away. I'll fly away. Well, today, normally when I tell this story, I put it all away at the end. But today, we're going to leave it out here so that everybody, including the people who are in the back, can see it when they come up to receive communion. So we're going to leave it right here for now. But after the dismissal, when you all come up and help Cindy, Mother Cindy, with doing the dismissal, you can help me put it away at that point, but we're going to leave it up right now. So we have this yellow background and the tree and the birds and the nests. That's right. All right. Thank you all very much for being part of this. I'm really glad you all were here. And you can go back and sit with your associated adults. whether they are your parents or grandparents or whoever else you want to sit with from your family. There we go. I'm going to move this up just a little. Thank you all for your patience with the story. One of the challenges of doing these stories in this kind of a context is that it is hard for you who are in the back to see what on earth is going on up here. So take a moment as you come forward to communion and just think about where you might be in this story as well. Because you might be a bird, or maybe you are a nest that provides some shelter, or maybe you're a tree, or maybe you're the person planting seeds, or maybe you're all of the above, depending on what role you're in at a given time. So that's my thought for you to consider as you come forward today. Amen.
In peace we pray to you, Lord God, for all people in their daily life and work.
For our families, friends, and neighbors, and for those who are alone.
For this community, the nation, and the world.
For all who work for justice, freedom, and peace.
For the just and proper use of your creation. For all who are in danger, sorrow, or any kind of trouble.
For those who minister to the sick, the friendless, and the needy.
For the peace and unity of the Church of God.
For all who proclaim the gospel and all who seek the truth.
For Michael, our presiding bishop, and Frank, our bishop, and all bishops and other ministers.
For all who serve God.
For the special needs and concerns of this congregation, for those in need of healing, Liz Corley, Joyce Shaw, Polly Kane, and Christy Skalek. For those who are homebound, for the safety of all those who serve abroad, including Will Leibel. Hear us, O Lord.
For your mercy is great.
We thank you, Lord, for all the blessings of this life, for those with special celebrations, for those celebrating birthdays, Mallory Halterman, Gail Jolly, Raymond Cardinal, Katie Liu, and Gage Skinner. For those celebrating anniversaries, Lauren and Joy Waldo, Lou and Linda Scales, Rick and Claudia Mahaffey, Greg and Harriet Graham. Thanksgiving for our partnership with Martinez Elementary School, the Claiborne and 143 Ministries. We will exalt you, O God, our King.
Praise your name.
We pray for all who have died, that they may have a place in your eternal kingdom. Henry Brantley. Lord, let your loving kindness be upon them.
We put their trust in you.
We pray to you also for the forgiveness of our sins. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy upon us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness. And by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
My beloved, the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Just one note before we go into our offertory hymn, which during week time we are not collecting an offertory, but you are encouraged to give, and there's a plate in the back. Before we start singing Amazing Grace, one of the joyful things this morning is joy. It's having Joy Waldo back with us worshiping. Joy, raise your hand. Joy is doing battle with lung cancer, and look at that beautiful woman. Just look at her. Thanks be to God that you are with us. Thank you. All right, Luke, you get them started? Can y'all sing this one? Do you know it?
Amazing grace.
My beloved, the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who on the first day of the week overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name, saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy and gracious Father, in your infinite love you made us for yourself. And when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you, in your mercy, sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me. Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him. In the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia. Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia.
My beloved, the gifts of God for the people of God.
As I went down to the river to pray, about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown? Good Lord, show me the way. Oh, sisters, let's go down, let's go down, come on down. Oh, sisters, let's go down, down to the river to pray. As I went down to the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the robe and crown? Good Lord, show me the way. Oh, brothers, let's go down, let's go down, come on down. Oh, brothers, let's go down, down to the river to pray. So I went down to the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown? Good Lord, show me the way. Oh, sinners, let's go down, let's go down, come on down. Oh, sinners, let's go down, down to the river to pray. As I went down to the river to pray, studying about that good old way, who shall wear the starry crown? Good Lord, I wandered so aimless, life filled with sin. I wouldn't let my dear Savior in. Then Jesus came like a stranger in the night. Oh, praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more darkness. Oh, praise the Lord, I saw the light. Just like a blind man, I wandered along. Worries and fears I claimed for my own. And like a blind man that God gave back his sight. Oh, praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light.
My beloved, always remember how short life is and how little time we have to gladden the hearts of those who travel with us. So be quick to love and make haste to be kind. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Let's fly away.
Little finger picks on, so it'll sound real loud and harsh, and it's an acquired taste for a lot of people, so my wife included.
They don't let banjos in at St. Paul's.
All right. Alleluia, alleluia. Let us go forth into the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Spirit, singing alleluia, alleluia. I messed up.
Thank you.
yourself from the other child.